surprise, motherfucker!
Hey, what's up, guys? Here's a quick guide on Mage Arena 2 so you can get your imbued god cape. First, you need to have Mage Arena 1 done, 75 magic, and cast all three god spells 100 times in the Mage Arena. Then, ask Collodion for more challenges. He gives you an enchanted symbol to hunt down followers from Ceridoman, Guthix, and Zamorak. Our goal is to kill each follower and bring its remains back to Collodion one at a time. This map shows us all the different locations the followers might be at. We're going to use the enchanted symbol as a hot-cold device and find the location of the followers before we go in for the kill. Take an inventory of cheap food and a stamina potion and go hunt down the first follower. Activating the enchanted symbol damages you and tells you if you're getting warmer or colder as you run around. Keep in mind that the followers can move locations about every 45 minutes, and the symbol will tell you when you activate it if they have. Once you get to the area where the symbol is very hot, go back to the Mage Arena bank and gear up for the first fight. We need to use the god spells that we unlocked against each respective follower. I highly recommend also using the charge spell to make the god spells more powerful. This requires 80 magic, but you can boost it from 75 in multiple ways. The easiest being to use an imbued heart, and then use the spell. But if you don't have an imbued heart, you can also go to the Nightmare Zone and sip an Overload or Super Magic Potion, and use the charge spell inside before going back to the Wildy. It lasts for 6 minutes. These staves are awesome to have because they let you auto-cast each different god spell. The followers all have very low magic defense, so you can get away with wearing some Black Dehyde for extra protection during the fight and against PKers. Bringing Rings of Recoil can also help out to kill the boss quicker. I recommend bringing anywhere between 50 and 75 casts of each god spell for each fight. Once we're geared up, we can take our enchanted symbol and run back to where we found the follower. You want to pray magic against all the followers and stay out of their melee range. They can hit up to 43 if your prayers aren't enabled. They can all cast Ice Barrage and Teleblock. You can move out of the way before the Ice Barrage hits you, and the Teleblock will last for 1 minute if you have Protect from Magic on. The Zamorak follower has a special attack where he charges up a ball and shoots it at you. The closer you are, the more damage it'll do. If you run far enough away from him, it won't hit you at all. The Ceridoman follower has a special attack where he swings a sword at you and sends a wave in your direction. If you don't dodge it, it'll grab you and stun you, pulling you close to him so he can melee you. Simply walk away from it. And finally, the Guthix follower has a special attack where he spawns orbs on the ground that starts to heal him. Simply attack them and destroy them. They only have 20 health each. Keep in mind that the followers are all very accurate and can hit hard. The biggest challenge will be constantly DPSing them without having to eat too much. Try to hide behind a tree or something when you need to eat to prevent them from attacking you. Now, all you need to do is repeat the process of locating the followers and then gearing up and killing them 3 times for each type of remains. After you finish each kill, you can either go back to the mage bank or teleport out so that you can bank your items and restore your health. Keep in mind that you cannot bank the remains, so you'll need to run through the Wildy with them. I recommend bringing a wilderness sword to instantly slash the webs, as well as some food in case you get attacked on your return. Here's some final tips. Set your player attack options to right-click only. Although be careful because you can still misclick if you're manual casting in Skull. Eat an anglerfish before you go out for the kill to boost your max hit points. Take an antidote with you as you're locating and killing the followers, as sometimes they might be near poison spiders. Also, turn auto-retaliate off so that you're not pulled into the monster. Once you've turned in all the remains, you can give Collodion one of your god capes and he'll imbue it for you. Mini quest complete. If you want more pairs of imbued god capes, you must locate and kill only the follower for the respective god cape you want and give the remains to Collodion. Well guys, that's all for today's guide. Thanks for watching. Leave a like if this video helped you out and subscribe to my channel. Enjoy your best in slot mage cape. See you next time. I like the Wildy sword because it cuts through the webs every f***ing time.